Yesterday we started, well, not yesterday, a few days ago we started learning about Lashon Hara. Lashon Hara is when you speak bad about somebody even though it's true. There's an Aveda called Motzi Shemra, which is when you speak bad about somebody and it's not true. That's even worse. But Lashon Hara is even if it's true what you're saying, nevertheless, it's called Lashon Hara. And the din is like this, whether you tell it in front of him or whether you tell causing Lashon Hara to happen, like we learned before, if somebody speaks good about somebody in front of their enemy, which is going to cause them to speak Lashon Hara, so then obviously it's all part of Lashon Hara. Now the din is, one second, the din is, what happens if everybody knows about it already? So the din is, once three people know about it, everybody knows about it. So the din is, it's not really considered Lashon Hara because everybody knows anyway, unless if your intention is to spread it more than it was before. You know, you say something that people, these people don't know yet. And you say it, so then it's Lashon Hara, even though more than three people know about it. What?
If you're saying it, obviously your intention is for...
No, maybe it's just gossip, but everybody knows about it anyway. Just to open up a conversation. How do you open up a conversation? Lashon Hara. So that's the... Now it says, how do you get rid of Lashon Hara? Okay, so he says, if you're a Talmud Chacham, go learn Torah. If you're an amoritz that's not able to learn Torah, just, he says, yashpil daiti, become humble and say, why am I speaking bad about somebody else? I'm not any better than them. Huh? That's right, so don't speak Lashon Hara. Yeah, then he quotes the Gemara, Rabbi Yemir says like this, four types of people, four groups of people, do not, ein mekablus p'nei ashchina, that means they don't receive the divine presence. Who are the four? Leitzim, mockers, Chanofim, flatterers, people that flatter everybody. Shekodim, liars. And Misapir Lashon Hara. Each one of these, they actually learn now from a pasuk. That says, Meshiv Leitzim LaYoshav, or it says, Meshay Chodes Leitzitzim, or it says, Kilei Lefanav Chanav Ba Shekodim, it says, David Shekodim Leikin Lenegenenov, Lashon Hara, it says, these are all derived from Sukkim, that you're not allowed to, that these types of people flattering somebody, is also not allowed. The only reason why Yaakov Avinu did it was because he wanted to find favor in his eyes that he shouldn't kill him. That's the level of Pikuach Nefesh. Someday, then it is allowed. But like this, time to flatter somebody, the Gemara calls Kat Chanofim Chanifa, which is not a good thing to have.
Why is it to make somebody feel good about themselves is bad?
Something else.
No, if flattering doesn't mean that. It's like flattering an evil person that does bad and you flatter him.
For what? Like, it's so great that you did this evil
act? Yeah.
Oh.
Or, no, flattering somebody for good things is good because then you build up.
I know, that's what
No, but he's saying when people, bad people, to flatter them for what they do.
Oh, all right.
So then it's obviously forbidden. Okay, next. There's a thing called nekama. Revenge. So it's a negative commandment in the Torah. The Torah says leisikim. You're not allowed to take revenge. What's revenge? So the Gemara gives an example. Somebody comes, you come to somebody and say, "Lend me your axe." This is what in Gemara's time. Lend me your axe. You tell me no. Yet tomorrow you come to me and say, "Lend me your axe." They said, "No, you didn't lend me. I'm not lending you." You didn't give me candy, I'm not giving you candy. Not your candy, the candy. So then the din is, that's called nekama. There's another din called lesitard, netita. What's netita? Netita is like this. I say, lend me your axe, you say no. Next day you come to me and say, lend me the axe. So nekama is, I say no, you didn't lend me, I'm not giving you. Netita means, no, I say, I'm giving you because I'm not like you. I'm going to give you the axe, not like you, that you didn't give it to me. I'm going to be better than you, and I'm going to give it. That's also a negative commandment in the Torah. It's called netita. And that's also forbidden. Okay? So what's the halacha? What should you do, the Torah says? Even though the guy doesn't do it for you, you do it for him anyway. But you don't tell him, I'm not like you. Then you get a love. But basically, even though a guy is not kind to you, he doesn't do things for you, you do things for him. Even though he doesn't lend you the axe, you lend him your axe. Okay. It was called Ma'avir al Midasa, by the way. Okay. Why? So it says in Halacha, it says, what should a person think? The world is not worthy of taking revenge over. The world is hot air. But like people say always, the world is not worthy of worrying over. Not worth it. It's a temporary world. It's full of hot air. You don't worry or do things like that. A person should be mavir al midaysav, because it says, kol ha-mavir al midaysav, by the way, somebody who changes his midays, he says in the Gemara, mechlun le'yakol ha-vein-aysav, all your sins are forgiven. Because then Hashem, because again, Hashem works deed for deed, right? So if you, a guy does something bad to you and you don't take revenge, on the contrary, you do good to him, so that's what Hashem does. We do bad to Hashem by sinning, and Hashem will still forgive us. So that's the, what's the problem? Okay, good. Now, it says, how do you, but there's a kosher way of revenge. Kosher revenge. How do you do that? He says, by you becoming a better person. You want to get back at somebody? It's not by screaming at him, yelling at him, taking revenge. It's by, he says like this. That's automatically the way you're going to take revenge. Why? Because he's going to be jealous and be upset that you're becoming a better person than him. So it's going to bother him. And therefore, but if you do, and that's like this, Torah says, don't, what's the expression they use in English? Don't lower yourself to their level.
Stoop.
Don't stoop yourself to that. Don't stoop to their level. On the contrary, you instead, rather than lowering yourself to their level, elevate yourself to a higher place. And that will kill them even more. That will kill them even more because they see you're becoming a better person because of it. It's like, Chazal tell us, somebody wants to make you nervous. Somebody wants to get you angry. Yeah? And that's what they're trying to do. And you just ignore it. Just ignore it, and it makes them even angrier.
Yeah.
They're trying to make you angry. They're trying to get you, and you don't respond accordingly. You don't react. So it kills them even more. And that's the Torah way of doing it, because then you're doing something positive. Okay, Netira is also, like we said, Netira is also forbidden. Kids are said, again, what do you do by Netira? Just forget about it. You do what you got to do. Just because the person's not a mensch doesn't mean you shouldn't be a mensch. In fact, there was a story with my father. I heard this not from my father. Somebody else told me. There was a guy, there was a very chutzpahdik once to my father. And, you know, the rabbis get that a lot of times. But my father was very nice to the person. He spoke very nicely to him. So his associate rabbi went over to him and he said to him, the guy spoke so rudely to you. Why? He said, because he's not a mensch, I shouldn't be a mensch. Because he's rude, I should be rude. Why should I be rude? Because he's rude. One thing has nothing to do with the next. We need to be above all this revenge and, you know, Lashon Hara. We need to be above it. No grudges.
But there is a pasuk
that
says, "Latet
liishki drachav
kifri
medos." No.
If he is no good, you have to be no good for him.
Why do you have to go there? Why don't you say a pasuk and tell him, "Imchaset tischazat, imchad novel tis bara, mikish tis
battle." Same thing.
No, but that's not. No, that's different. With a bad person, it doesn't mean you act bad towards him. Because, like Shlomo Melech says, then you're going to become like him. Don't answer a fool, because then you'll become like him. You'll become the same fool he is. Yeah.
Yeah,
no, so.
If I'm going to do what I do, he will change.
It means protect yourself and don't allow it to be stepped on. There's a big difference, by the way, by be allowing yourself to be hurt, made fun of, you know, insulted, or responding after the fact. There's two different things. There's two different things. If somebody wants to hit you, say, okay, hit me because I'm a nothing, and Hashem wants, you'll hit me. No, you have to stop it. If the person hits you, to smack him back would be nekama. But stopping yourself from getting hit is not revenge. You're stopping the person from hitting you in a negative way or insulting you or whatever. It's after the fact. You want to take revenge. And that's not a good thing to do because it's a bad midah. Even when Hashem says in Chumash, Nekayim nikmas b'nei Yisrael me'isa midyanim, there's certain exceptions to the rule. You know? Lasis nekama v'agoyim techechel balumim, like we say in every day in davening. There is a concept of nekama, but not between Jews, number one, because the Pasuk says, Leisika v'leisita is b'nei amecha. With the enemies, if they fight you, you have to fight back. I mean, that's a whole different story. Okay. So it's okay to